The interceptor what has been used for this neutralization purpose is a three-stage vehicle with two stages of solid propellant and then a kill vehicle. You can see in the picture the full vehicle, the second stage and the kill vehicle and the kill vehicle, which is approximately about 19 meters, 19 tons, and 13 meters is the length of the missile. It has an inertially guided system and a divert and attitude control system, DACS, and a IAR seeker for the terminal guidance. The challenges in this mission are, firstly, the hit-to-kill mechanism, meaning your accuracy has to be very, very, very good. Second, for a low Earth orbit satellite, the closing in velocities, or the relative velocities, are very high, more than about 10 kilometers per second. These are the challenges in this mission, what Mission Shakti. When you look at the whole scenario, the detection and tracking systems located at four places detect and track the satellite and pass on to the command and control center. The command and control center works out the scenario and the possibility of interception, and then to the launch complex informs that there is a target and the interception is feasible from that launch complex. Then the launch complex works on it, works on the missile, and all the operations which are required on the missile will be generated and continuously computes in the ground guidance system the exact time of the launch for the interception, what needs to take place, and launches the missile on its own. The complete operations what have defined are automatic without human intervention anywhere.